Namaskar. First of all, I will thank Narodko for arranging this today's seminar. Secondly, I will congratulate Chitore Sahib to become a director ESNP. And of course, Darade Sahib is our new chief in DP. So we will welcome both of them. Of course, from my side, I wish good luck and extend my full support to Chitore Sahib as well as Darade Sahib, because I am going to work under both. Acha, I will come to the subject. Recently, in 2016, December, government of India has published MOUD guidelines. Actually, I will go 2 years back. When Chitore Sahib has come as a chief in a DP and our Honorable MC Ajay Mehta Sahib come as a commissioner, then our actual EODB work starts working. That time, this MOUD issue was taken with the government of India, that this is required to be streamlined because it is taking a lot of time. So, Additional Secretary MOUD, Mr. Misra Sahib, take it very seriously. And then so many things, even stakeholders had so many meetings with the government of India. And finally, government of India in December 2016 has issued new MOUF guidelines. The best part of that guideline was that MOUF NOC, MOUF clearance will be available at the state level or at the ULB's level, urban local bodies. So that was the best part, because it will save at least 9 months to 1 year to get the MOUF clearance. Based on that, government of Maharashtra has again issued the 154 directives in April, and simultaneously issued a notice under 37(1AA). So from that, on that basis, we have started forming the environmental cell. So basically, that MOUF clearance is required for the 4 categories. Up to 5,000, nothing is required. 5,000 to 20,000, then 20,000 to 50,000, 50,000 to 1,50,000 square meter, and above 1.5 lakh square meter. So, above 1.5 lakh square meter, we have to go to the government. But in Mumbai, I think above 1.5 lakh square meter proposals are now very less. Up to 5,000, nothing is required. 5,000 to 20,000, it is a self-certifications, basically. So, consultant has to submit his report and he has to self-certify. Based on this notifications, we have now formed the environmental cell. It is comprising of 6 members. 3 are internal from the MCGM sites and 3 are the external expertise. External expertise, and we hope that from 15th of August we will start functioning. We have also started to prepare the software application for that, so that this clearance will be available within 10 days. Presently, offline procedure we are almost finalized, and we will issue that circular for the procedure in next 8 days. I will just brief about the accreditation of the qualified building environment auditor. See, it is expected that the proposal is to be submitted by qualified building environmental auditor. We will say it is a QBEA. So he is required to be registered with the QCI, Quality Council of India. He can get registered with the National Productivity Council, then Green Building Council or Bureau of Energy Efficiency. I think Green Building Council and BEE offices are in Mumbai only. So he can get registered anywhere in the from these institutions and submit his proposals as per the categories. Qualification is also very much lenient, that architect having degree or diploma also can be a consultant, town planner can be the consultants. postgraduate in the environmental science can be also eligible, as well as civil engineer and mechanical engineer with the electrical diploma are also eligible. Of course, some experience of 3 years is required in the respective field, and its validity is 5 years. You have to renew it every 5 years. What will be the role of the environmental cell? Actually, role of the environmental cell, that whatever the proposal will received from the consultant, they have to go through it and they have to recommend. They will not refuse. They will recommend what is to required to be done. If the proposal is okay, they will say yes. Otherwise, they will recommend that this is required to be done in this field. And this proposal will directly go to the respective deputy chief engineer building proposal as an approving authority. There is no in between. So, deputy chief engineer building proposal will see whether their recommendation is okay or not. If he feels that recommendation is required to be changed, he can change it or he can approve it as it is. Once deputy chief engineer building proposal has approved the recommendations, then your MOF clearance is happened. So, we have made such a simple procedure. Of course, yes, simple procedure. So, I hope that we will in the next 15-20 days, we will start functioning that. I will request all to get registered first, because without registration, proposal cannot be submitted. So, registration of consultant is very much essential for this clearance. I think I should not talk much, because already we are late. So I will like to stop over here. I will again thanks Naredco to give me opportunity to speak for in front of you. Thank you very much.